Back in the 1780s, this guy, Italian scientist Luigi Galvani, struck dead frogs' legs with an electric spark, and they twitched. He demonstrated the electrical basis of our nerve impulses. Now, hundreds of years later, the same direct current technique is being used to supercharge our brains. Galvani and Volta, another Italian scientist, debated whether direct current was the spark of life, or if it just triggered the movement of dead muscles. The scientific community progressed towards Team Volta, thinking that electricity triggered dead muscle movement, not life itself. The action in the scientific world was mirrored in fiction, with the reanimation of Dr. Frankenstein's creature in Mary Shelley's famous work.
A flash of lightning illuminated the object and discovered its shape plainly to me.
Direct current stimulation continued to be used for therapeutic purposes, like treating sleep disorders and mental illness. In recent years, transcranial direct current stimulation, TDCS for short, has been used to significantly enhance our working memory and relieve depression. It works by a constant low current, think a 9-volt battery, travelling through electrodes to excite neurons in a specific brain region. It makes it easier for lots of neurons to fire and boosts your cognitive ability. In one study, TDCS was used on stroke patients suffering from speech problems. After the treatment, the patient showed significant improvement in naming common nouns, even after a retest 1 week later. In another study, when researchers applied TDCS to the motor cortex, it raised participants' threshold for pain. A PET scan showed that following the electrical stimulation, there was an increase in the release of opioids in the brain, acting as painkillers. We're on the brink of a new understanding of our minds, just like when Mary Shelley wrote Frankenstein, and we were on the brink of a new understanding of electricity in our bodies. The clinical benefits and applications of TDCS are almost too good to be true. So much so that people have started assembling their own kits at home and stimulating their brains. It's not quite bringing things back to life, but by using a spark of electrical current, just like Frankenstein did with his or her creature, we're creating an altered self. Seriously, don't try this at home. It's complicated. To precisely activate the right area comes with lots of experience, and stimulating certain parts of the brain can reduce activity in others. We don't know if there are long-term risks. Are we creating modern-day monsters? In a recent study, people were left alone in a room and asked to entertain themselves with their thoughts, or if they wanted, they could give themselves an electric shock during the thinking period. Over two-thirds of men prefer to administer electric shocks to themselves instead of being left alone with their thoughts. Perhaps there's a Dr. Frankenstein in us all. Speaking of Mary Shelley's famous work, a modern adaptation of Frankenstein, Frankenstein MD, is a monstrously good new series. It takes a look at science through the questionable experiments of Victoria Frankenstein, MD, in training. Click on the annotation to check it out, or there's a link in the description. And subscribe to Braincraft for a new brainy episode every week.